So just to be clear, this is not New York. Actually, this is New Jersey. Rooms aren't this big in New York.
Five right now, and the train leaves at 7:11, and I might be late.
Yeah, ideally I'd want to give myself a little bit more time to get to the subway, but you know, some days you just wake out of bed and just don't move for like 20 minutes. It just happens.
Channel. So last 10 weeks I got to intern in New York City for National Australia Bank. I'll be honest, I was a little bit nervous at first, you know, to a point where I'd start saying the really weirdest and most awkward stuff. So as a result of this internship, I actually got to live in New York City and live in Manhattan for the first time in my life. When you intern in the city, you kind of feel like you're surviving, you're not thriving. I'm giving you guys these five top tips that I have because I want to make sure that your experience in New York is the best that it can be. Number one, your roommates. Your roommates matter a lot. Like, shout out to Enoch and Mana for being the best roommates I could have had in Manhattan because they made my life so much better. It's really important that you room with your friends because your friends make your day. If you're having a really slow day in the office or you just had a lot of work and you're tired, your friends are the people that can bring you back up. If you thought that having friends makes your experience 10 times better, having strangers makes your experience 10,000 times worse. You know, strangers can get really bad because if you don't like your roommate, that's when things go bad. One of my friends lived in NYU housing and she had to share a room with someone else. Things would be really weird. Like, they would have suite mates who they didn't even talk to. To a point where, like, if they saw their suite mate in the suites, they wouldn't even say hi. It was just weird. Having that atmosphere in your apartment just makes life so much worse. Number two, location of your apartment. I just realized I didn't turn on the light over here. Oh wow, I changed things. Now, things to consider for your location include, do you want to go out a lot or do you want to stay at home a lot? If you want to go out every single night after work, living in Midtown is the move. That's where everything's going on, that's where everything's happening. Go live in Midtown. But if you really want to be chill and just have a chill night every single night after work, go to Upper West Side, go somewhere a little bit quieter. I personally lived in Upper West Side because I knew I was not going to be going out every single night and I wanted a good night's sleep. At the same time, rent costs differ all throughout the city. Upper East Side, known as one of the most bougie parts of the city. Upper West Side isn't too expensive in my opinion. I personally paid about $1,670 per month for rent. And Midtown can get really expensive. I've been offered $2,000 a month for rent. Though I've had friends who've had ways where they would finesse like a one bedroom office space and turn it into a three bedroom apartment. Another thing, subway station. Be on the lookout on what subway stations are close by. Try to minimize the amount of walking you have to do in the morning and make sure that when you're taking your commute, try to make your subway line a one-way route. Try to have as little transfers as possible because transfers really are the reason for longer commutes. Number three, networking. There are so many different people that you could connect with in the city. So many different career paths happening. So before you come to the city, try to make a list of friends, family members, alumni of university that you could potentially meet up with, get coffee with, get dinner with, get lunch with, anybody, because those opportunities, those interactions are a great way to understand what other people are doing with their lives and what careers are possible in New York City. Tip number four, get a month-long Metro card. It costs $127 for 1 month of unlimited rides. One ride usually costs $2.75 without the unlimited pass, so let's just say that you decided to do two trips per day for 4 weeks for 5 days a week. So that's about 40 trips, $2.75 per trip. So that would amount to about $110. Yes, the monthly pass may be a little bit more expensive, but consider the fact that when you're in New York City, you kind of want to have the freedom to go wherever you want, try to explore different parts of the city, and you will definitely see yourself spending more than $127 on trips around the city. So definitely get the monthly pass. Also, for subway rides in general, invest in a nice pair of headphones. Having them for the commute is great because you could listen to podcasts, you can listen to audiobooks, you can listen to music, you can listen to anything, and you're gonna feel like you're actually being productive during your commute. Tip number five, try out MealPal. First off, I just wanna say I was not told or endorsed by MealPal to do this, and I also don't think this applies to everybody, but let me explain what MealPal is first. MealPal is this online mobile app. If one day you wanna get lunch through MealPal, you go onto their app, you find a bunch of different stores that offer MealPal services, and you pick a store, you reserve a lunch for a certain time, and during that scheduled time, you go pick up the lunch in less than 2 minutes and you get that lunch. MealPal costs around $7 per meal, though I got to spend about $5 per meal through promotions. New York City lunch prices can get as at least $12 a meal. Through MealPal, I'd be getting meals that should be $12, but in fact end up being $5 a meal for me. It's a great way to save money. It's also gonna save you a lot of time too because you get to skip the lines of waiting in line for lunch. And also you don't have to make your own lunch, which for me, I'm way too lazy and I don't have time to make my own lunch. But yeah, that is all the tips I have for you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys found this helpful. If you guys have any other tips on what people should do as a New York intern, definitely put it down in the comments below. I wanna see what you guys have to say. But on that note, it's been great coming back onto YouTube. See you guys next time. All right. So I just want to give a shout out to the other two interns at National Australia Bank, Gabby and Monique, for making my experience in NAB really, really fun. I also want to thank you, Rick, for being a really great mentor, for sharing all your great stories, and also for really developing me as a worker and as a person throughout this whole internship. So thank you guys so much, and I hope we can all stay connected.